Hello my dear students, welcome back again. We'll continue our topic derivatives of higher order, the same exercise 1.5. Okay, one formula I have written here. See, if y equal to x plus tan x, then show that cos square x into d square y by dx square minus 2y plus 2x equal to 0. We have to prove this. Here d square y by dx square is there. Means what is d square y by dx square? Second order derivative of y with respect to x. It means we have to differentiate given function y with respect to x two times. So take the given function, let y equal to x plus tan x. Differentiate with respect to x. Derivative of y with respect to x is divide by dx. Now here on right hand side, divide dx of x plus tan x is equal to. Now derivative of x with respect to x is 1 plus derivative of tan x is 6 square x. This is the value of divide by dx. Again differentiate with respect to x again. Okay, now derivative of dy by dx on right hand side, dy dx of 1 plus 6 square x. We know that derivative of dy by dx is d square y by dx square. Now here, take the derivative of each term, dy dx of 1 plus dy dx of 6 square x. Derivative of 1, what is constant? Derivative of constant term is 0. Plus derivative of 6 square x. First take the derivative of power. Derivative of 6 square x is 2 sec x into dy dx of sec x. This can be written as 2 sec x, and derivative of sec x is sec x into tan x. Therefore, d square y by dx square is sec x into sec x, sec square x, 2 sec square x into tan x. But we have to prove cos square x into d square y by dx square minus 2y plus 2x is equal to 0. Take its LHS. What is the LHS? Cos square x into d square y by dx square minus 2y plus 2x. Now here we have to substitute the value of d square y by dx square and y. Cos square x d square y by dx square is sec square x 2 sec square x into tan x minus 2 y is equal to x plus tan x minus 2x. Okay, now simplify this. This cos square x, cos theta is 1 upon sec theta. So cos square x we can write 1 upon sec square x into 2 sec square x into tan x multiply by minus 2 minus 2x plus 2 tan x minus 2x. Okay. Minus plus, this is plus 2 tan x plus 2x. Minus 2x plus 2x cancel. Sec square x also will cancel. 2 into tan x, 2 tan x, minus 2x here, minus 2 into tan x, here is sign minus, 2 tan x minus 2 tan x is equal to 0, therefore LHS is equal to RHS. Is that it? We have proved this, cos square x into d square y by dx square minus 2y plus 2x equals to 0. Okay. Now we will take Next one. And the same exercise. If sec inverse,
say that
if sec inverse 7x cube minus 5y cube, 7x cube minus 5y cube upon 7x cube plus 5y cube is equal to L, they show that d square y by dx square equal to 0. Show that d square y by dx square equal to 0. This is a given function. And we have to show that d square y by dx square equal to 0. D square y by dx square is the second order derivative of y with respect to x. So take the given function. Let sec inverse 7x cube minus 5x cube upon 7x cube plus 5x cube is equal to f. Now on left hand side, here is inverse function, sec inverse. It goes on right hand side, it becomes trigonometric. So therefore, 7x cube, there is y square. 7x cube minus 5y cube, 7x cube plus 5y cube. 7x cube minus 5y cube upon 7x cube plus 5y cube is equal to, this inverse becomes trigonometric, it is taken. So denominator is 1. Now here we have to use component and dividend rule. Yog ko bhi kriya. What is component and dividend rule? If the ratio is A upon B, it becomes A plus B upon A minus B. In the numerator, numerator plus denominator, and in denominator, numerator minus denominator. This is the component and dividend rule. Apply here. By component and dividend rule, this becomes 7x cube minus 5y cube plus 7x cube plus 5y cube upon 7x cube minus 5y cube. Numerator minus denominator, so its sign will be changed. It becomes minus 7x cube minus 5y cube is equal to, on right hand side also use component as dividend rule. It becomes sec m plus 1 upon sec m minus 1. We know that m is constant, therefore sec m is also constant. Therefore, sec m plus 1 upon sec m minus 1 is also the constant term. So, we denote this constant term is equal to c. Now, see here, 5y cube get cancelled, minus 5y cube plus 5y cube get cancelled. Here, 7x cube minus 7x cube get cancelled. Remaining, 7x cube plus 7x cube, 14x cube, minus 5y cube minus 5y cube, minus 10y cube. Take constant term is equal to c. C is equal to sec m plus 1 upon sec m minus 1. Now here divide by 2. 2 7s are 14. 2 5s are 10. So 7x cube upon minus 5y cube. Take minus 10 outside here. Upon 5y cube is equal to c. Say this equation 1. Now take the cross multiplication. 7x cube minus 7x cube is equal to c into 5y cube. 5c y cube. Now differentiate this. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. Minus 7. Derivative of x cube. Derivative of x cube is 3x square equal to 5, c constant, keep it outside. Derivative of 5 cube is y square into dy by dx. Now here we have to substitute the value of c, minus 21 x square, 5 3s are 15, value of c is minus 7 x cube upon 5 y cube into y square into dy by dx, y square into dy by dx. Here 5 3s are 15, y square get cancelled. Now this minus 21 x square upon 3 into minus 3 into minus 7, that is also minus 21, minus 21 x cube upon y into dy by dx. Now take the cross multiplication, minus 21 x square into y upon minus 21 x cube is equal to dy by dx. Okay, here x square get cancelled, 21 get cancelled, therefore dy by dx is equal to y upon x. But we have to show that d square y by dx square equal to 0, dy by dx is the first order derivative of y with respect to x. So again differentiate. Differentiate with respect to x again. Now derivative of dy by dx is d square y by dx square. And now here use the quotient rule of derivative. U upon v. What is the derivative of u upon v? Here u equal to y and v equal to x. Derivative of u upon v is v into derivative of u minus u into derivative of v. So u equal to y, v equal to x, x into dy by dx, v into derivative of u, minus u minus y, and derivative of x is 1, divided by v square, that is x square, is equal to x, dy by dx. What is dy by dx? Y upon x, y into 1 is y, upon x. This x gets cancelled. D square y by dx square is equal to y minus y upon x square, that is 0 upon x square, that is 0. Hence d square y by dx square is equal to 0. That's the proof. We understand this. Now we will take the one more sum. Now see, the next one is, if x is equal to cos t and y equal to, if x is equal to cos t and y is equal to e raised to mt, e raised to mt, then show that, what we have to prove? 1 minus x square into d square y by dx square, 1 minus x square into d square y by dx square, minus x dy by dx, minus x dy by dx, minus m square y equal to 0. Okay, two functions are given and we have to do this. 1 minus x square into d square y by dx square, minus x square y by dx, minus m square y equal to 0. Now, let x is equal to cos t. From this we can write t equal to cos inverse x. This trigonometric becomes inverse. Now, y equal to e raised to mt. Therefore, y equal to e raised to m, t is equal to cos inverse x. And now differentiate this. Differentiate with respect to x. Now derivative of y with respect to x is dy by dx. On right hand side, derivative of e raised to m cos inverse x, that is d by dx of e power m cos inverse x. Now its derivative is e raised to m cos inverse x. Derivative of exponential function is the exponential function into derivative of its power into dy dx of m cos inverse x. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to e raised to m cos inverse x into m. M is constant, which is in multiple of the function, so keep it outside. Now, derivative of cos inverse x, that is minus m upon root 1 minus x square. Now, simplify this. Dy by dx is equal to, this is y, minus my upon root 1 minus x square. Now, take the cross multiplication. Root 1 minus x square into dy by dx is equal to minus m y. Now differentiate this. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. On left hand side there are two functions. First function root 1 minus x square, second function dy by dx. Both the functions are in product form. So use product rule of derivative. Okay, this is root 1 minus x square, first function, into d by dx of second function, dy by dx, plus second function, dy by dx, into d by dx of first function, root 1 minus x square, is equal to minus m, and derivative of y with respect to x is dy by dx. Now simplify this. Root 1 minus x square, derivative of dy by dx is d square y by dx square plus dy by dx. Now derivative of root 1 minus x square, use the formula, derivative of root fx. What is the derivative of root fx? That is 1 upon 2 root fx into f dash x. Okay, this is 1 upon 2 root 1 minus x square into derivative of this term, 1 minus x square. Derivative of 1 is 0, and derivative of minus x square is minus 2x, is equal to minus m into dy by dx. Here 2 get cancelled. Now this, now in denominator root 1 minus x square is there, multiply by root 1 minus x square throughout this equation. Root 1 minus x square into root 1 minus x square is 1 minus x square into d square y by dx square plus dy by dx. Root 1 minus x square is cancelled, so it is minus x is equal to minus m into dy by dx into root 1 minus x square. Now see, minus m dy by dx is equal to minus my upon root 1 minus x square. Now here, dy by dx into root 1 minus x square, if we take the cross multiplication, root 1 minus x square into dy by dx will get minus my. So this becomes minus m into minus my. Okay? So this equation by 1. 1 minus x square into d square y by dx square minus x dy by dx is equal to m square y. So this 1 minus x square, what we have to do? 1 minus x square into d square y by dx square minus x dy by dx, and this term becomes negative. minus n square y equal to c. Hence the proof. Isn't it? Any doubt regarding to this? I think it is so simple. Once again, I want to remark that share this video with your friends and relatives. And lastly, subscribe my channel Sitaram Pandey NKGC on YouTube.